Now we're here with one of my favorite films at the festival. It's Claudette, and we're here with yet another Swiss filmmaker. Yes, and this time she's a petite jeune femme who is just rocking the festival, the Montreal World Film Festival, with her film Claudette. It's Sylvie Cachin. Bienvenue.
Merci.
And the movie Claudette is, well, you tell us what it's about, because I just loved it. I loved every moment of it. I love Claudette. It's a documentary. It's all true.
Thank you. It's a portrait about Claudette. Claudette is a hermaphrodite person. She's a prostitute, and she's fighting for the rights of sex workers.
Okay, she said she was a hermaphrodite. I want you to all get that. She's not a transsexual. But she is a prostitute. I'm sure they understood that. But a hermaphrodite. I know what that is.
In other words, it's intersexed. In other words, it's a person who was born with an ambivalence, a genital ambivalence.
Right.
When she was born, she
had sexual organs of both.
Yes.
Genders.
It was like as a baby, they couldn't know if she was really a boy, completely a boy, or completely a girl.
I can't imagine how that's possible, but that's the story.
Yeah, they say there are one person among 1,000 person who were born hermaphrodite.
Hermaphrodite. Now, hermaphrodite is different from a transsexual who's had a sexual reassignment operation.
How old is she now?
Now she's a little bit more than 70.
Oh, you're that's incredible. And she's still a prostitute.
Yeah. She's more retired, but she works.
She's still working. And she's a union organizer, too. She's trying to unionize and legalize prostitution.
In Geneva, the political situation about prostitution is that prostitution is legal.
In Switzerland, Geneva, Switzerland.
Switzerland, yes.
It's
legal.
And she wants to have a union now, right?
She works in a foreign association at the Swiss level and at the international level. And she's fighting for the rights of sex workers.
So this documentary is nothing but one prostitute after another. Anyway, how did you get involved with this, Sylvie? You're such a petite jolie jeune femme.
How did you meet Claudette? How did you do this?
I met her in a bar in my town. And I just found her a happy person and very joyful, and she had a little light in her eyes.
A glint, yeah. A gleam in her eyes.
Yeah, and it was like a happiness. And I wanted to know what is the mystery of this happiness. And I knew her for...
She has more sex than anybody I've ever seen in my whole life, basically.
Yes.
Basically. She's so happy.
That's why, I think so. She says that sex is keeps young. She's somebody who's living more than 10%. She's, hola.
Oh, Claudette didn't
Yes,
like
Claudette wants to tell her something,
tell
maybe.
Something. Claudette, what are you trying to say?
I can tell something about how I worked.
Sure.
When I decided to make a movie about her, because she was so fabulous, I told her, okay, let's make a movie. We were friends for 6 years.
Oh.
Already. And she told me, okay, I can make a movie with you. I do agree, but we won't speak about the family. And I said to her, okay, just do it, but I thought, I will never do a movie with her without speaking about the family.
And her family, it turns out, shock of shockers, she's married with 2 kids and how many grandchildren?
Yeah, she has a really traditional way of life on one part. She's married with a woman for 40 years, and she has a family, children and grandchildren.
That was the big shocker, the climax of the film. And this is the climax of the interview, because we have to go now, but it was fantastic having you here. Sylvie Cachin.
Thank you. Is that right? Yeah, it
Cachin.
Is.
Cachin. You can say it in your name again.
My name is Sylvie Cachin.
Cachin. But not Cochon. That's something else entirely. But and the film is Claudette, and we hope that it's coming to a theater near you very soon. Merci, mademoiselle.
Merci.